A Trump-appointed judge in Pennsylvania on Sunday put the brakes on a lawsuit brought by the Trump administration and the Republican Party seeking to stop Pennsylvania's vote-by-mail program, which was greatly expanded recently so that people could vote without having to live in fear of catching coronavirus. The Trump administration and the Republican Party didn't want this to happen because, as Trump has admitted, when you have more people voting, that spells doom for the Republican Party. They don't want people to vote from home. They don't want people to vote safely. So they're not going to let it happen. So here's the thing. Yesterday, the judge came out on a Sunday. It said, I'm going to halt this lawsuit that y'all have going right now. And by the way, they had actually been told that they had until this past Friday to turn over all of the evidence that they had regarding voter fraud in Pennsylvania, because that's why they filed the lawsuit, because they said there's too much fraud in Pennsylvania. You can't do this. You're going to ruin our elections with all the fraud you've got. And so the judge had said, okay, can you show us this? You've said actually in the filings that you have evidence. So you have until Friday to turn over all this evidence that you swear exists, but you haven't shown anybody. And then we'll go from there and we'll see what happens. Obviously, they didn't have the evidence, right? And so then on Sunday, the judge has to be like, you know what? There's so many cases like lawsuits happening in the lower courts, in the state courts. So I'm going to just abstain. We're going to abstain this entire lawsuit. I'm putting a stay on it. So the little lower court ones, the state courts, so that those can work themselves out. Again, this was a Trump-appointed judge. A judge by the name of Nicholas Ranjan of the U.S. District Court in Western District of Pennsylvania. And the reason Judge Nick went ahead and issued the ruling this way is because he didn't want to offend Donald Trump. But we know the truth of what actually happened here. You're not saying I'm putting the brakes on this because we've got state courts that are going to determine this. No, no. You're doing it because you know they don't have a case. But if you throw it out, you're going to become a villain to the Republican Party. And that's going to ruin your chances of ever getting appointed to an even higher court in the future, right? That's what you're worried about. That, because that's what would happen. And that's why you issued the ruling in this way. You know the truth. You know that they couldn't turn over that evidence because the evidence doesn't exist. They were given till Friday. They blew past the deadline. They don't have the evidence. And so you're just sitting there scratching your head on a Sunday thinking, my God, what am I going to do? How am I going to get out of this? And you came up with the best plan. You said, hey, yeah, you know, you got some state lawsuits happening. Why don't we just look at those? You know, maybe they'll come up with something better, and we'll just stay this lawsuit now. So that way, if evidence comes up in one of those lawsuits, I guess we could use it in this one. And if not, then we'll just be like, we forgot about this lawsuit. It's going to go away forever. This is ridiculous, folks. This is absolutely ridiculous. There is no widespread voter fraud. Trump has been trying to find it for years, and every time he has looked for it, he has failed. No matter how many loyal stooges he puts in charge of concocting voter fraud, they can't find it. And they've been looking. And the few instances we do have of voter fraud being committed, in-person voter fraud being committed, guess what? Every one of them's a Republican. So that's probably why they don't want to turn over the evidence either, because there's only a handful of them and all of them are Republicans. So not exactly making your case there. But hey, at least you got judges like this who are willing to soften the blow a little bit so you don't feel like such miserable failures.